CompsFromSpreadsheet is an After Effects script that will allow you to make template compositions in After Effects. Then, using data from a spreadsheet, make duplicates of those template comps and insert data from the spreadsheet into them as either text layers or AV layers. The latest version of CompsFromSpreadsheet in a sample project can be downloaded from aescripts.com/CompsFromSpreadsheet. Every line or row of your spreadsheet will represent a copy of one of your templates, and every column will hold data to be inserted into that copy. One of the columns of the spreadsheet will need to hold the name of the AE comp to use as a base. CompsFromSpreadsheet will make a dupe of that comp and use the data from the columns in that row to populate text layers, replace layers with either items in your project or import items to replace layers. Setting up a template comp is simple. To have a text layer receive text from the ISCII column of your spreadsheet, hit the Create Text Object button while you are in the comp that you want as a template. A window will pop up. Type ISCII in the field and hit OK. A text layer is created with the text caret ISCII. Caret is the funky symbol above the 6 on your keyboard. You don't have to use the button on the interface. Any text layer that starts with a caret symbol in either the source text or layer name will be targeted to receive data from the spreadsheet. You also don't have to name the text layer ISCII. You could call it anything you want, but naming it the same name as the spreadsheet column will make it automatically sync up when running the script. If you make a text layer named caret date, it will have today's date inserted into it. The default format is month, day, year numerically. You can change this by going into the settings. If you want to have a non-text layer in your comp replaced with an item in your project, name the layer that you want to target, pound, that's Shift-3, and the name of the column in your spreadsheet you want to sync to. So if you create a layer pound graphic, that layer will be replaced by the project item named in the graphic column of your spreadsheet. If you want AE to import a layer and place it in your comp, use the greater than sign. So in your template comp, the layer named greater than audio will be replaced by the file that resides at the path in the audio column of your spreadsheet. To get the proper path for a file, click on the Get File Path button and navigate to the file you want to use. The proper path will be displayed in a window that you can copy and paste into your spreadsheet. Finally, if you have a layer in your spreadsheet that is actually a pre-comp that contains target layers, you need to change the layer name to begin with an exclamation point. The name that follows is irrelevant, as this tells the script that it needs to copy the pre-comp, replace it, and process any layer that has been set up to receive data accordingly. Now that you have some template comps set up, you need to set up your spreadsheet. The very first row of your spreadsheet needs to contain the names for all the columns. If you have more than one composition in your project, you need to have a column named comp, which will hold the name of the template comp to be duplicated for each row. If you are updating text layers from your spreadsheet and need a new line in your text, you need to type less than symbol br greater than symbol instead of using a new line. Also, if you need a comma, you need to type less than symbol c greater than symbol. The script will replace these with their intended values at runtime. The final step before you can run the script is you need to convert your spreadsheet into a tab-delimited text doc. Despite its name, CompsFromSpreadsheet can't actually read a spreadsheet. If you try to feed the script your actual spreadsheet, it's going to choke. Most spreadsheet programs can convert to tab-delimited text easily. In Excel, just do Save As Text tab-delimited. Now you are ready to go. Click the Run CompsFromSpreadsheet button. A window will ask you to select your grid file. This is the tab-delimited text file you just created. Navigate to this file and select it and click OK. Remember, don't point it to your spreadsheet file. You need to select the tab-delimited text file. The Field Init window pops up. In the Field section, the top header represents the first line of your spreadsheet. The drop-down menu below contains all the target layers you created in your template compositions. If you use the same name in your template as in your spreadsheet, these will automatically be selected. Otherwise, you need to manually select. The next section of the Field Init window lets you specify how you want the newly created comps to be named. The default is to name it the line number of the spreadsheet. The first comp created will be named 2 because it came from the second line of the spreadsheet. Remember, line 1 is the column names. The next comp will be named 3, and so on. You can also choose to have the newly created comp retain their original name, or you can set it to receive a name from one of the spreadsheet columns. When you run the script, Each newly created comp will be set to render in the render queue using the default settings. If you wish to have a specific render template used for the run, hit the Render Settings button and select the appropriate template from the dropdown and hit Save Settings. If you want to always use these settings, click the Remember Settings checkbox before clicking Save Settings. Now you're ready to do the work. Click OK. The script goes through the tab-delimited text doc line by line. For each line, it duplicates the comp named in the comp column and puts it in the comps from spreadsheet folder. It then inserts any data from columns into the layers of the comp that are synced to it, then renames the newly created comp based on your settings and puts it in the render queue using either the default settings or the render template you chose. And that's it. You're all done. So the idea of comps from spreadsheet came from my old job. I used to work at a post house in Philadelphia, and we used to do a lot of work for AIG Auto Insurance. And what they would do is, every couple of months, they would send us about 3 or 4 different commercial templates that would have blank areas in the spot to insert a phone number. And then they'd send us a spreadsheet with like 80 lines on it, and each line would represent a different version of one of those 3 commercials. So the line spreadsheet would say, use template A and insert this phone number into it, and in the slate, this is the market you're supposed to put, and they'd have all sorts of other information that needed to be added from that spreadsheet. And it would take me about a day and a half to do. I'd take the 3 spots into the Avid, make copies of each one, and put all the data from that line in the spreadsheet into it and put it in a timeline. And it was extremely tedious, and usually around about the 30th line, mistakes would start happening because it was so boring. And after doing that about 4 or 5 different times, I decided to solve the problem in scripting in After Effects. And then, of course, once I was finished with it, we lost them as a client, and they never came back, and so it was really kind of a waste of time. And then a few years later, once AE Scripts came along, I thought it would be a nice little script for people to use, but it had, obviously had to be updated so that people could kind of configure it to, work the way they needed it. So, anyway, that's where the idea came from. I hope you enjoy it.